This means that even if governments were to ban cryptocurrencies, decentralized exchanges can still operate in those regions. A lot of newbies joining the crypto market might find it quite overwhelming to navigate just because the information are a lot. Before you can own any cryptocurrency, you need what we call an exchange. Do you even know that we have two different kinds of exchanges? We have centralized exchange and decentralized exchange. So in this video, we are going to be understanding what they mean, the difference between them, and if anyone is better than the other. If this sounds interesting to you, kindly give us a thumbs up. And if you want to learn more about finance in general, then you need to hit the subscribe button as I try to bring you as much information as soon as I can. I am not a financial advisor. This video is solely for educational and entertainment purposes. So let's get started. A cryptocurrency exchange is simply a place where you can buy, sell, and hold cryptocurrency. Every crypto exchange has its unique rules and regulation, but they all provide you access to widespread cryptocurrencies. Like I stated earlier, we have two different kinds of exchanges, centralized and decentralized exchanges. I'll begin with centralized exchanges. We can say centralized exchanges are similar to banks of today in the sense that they have owners, they follow rules and regulation, they are to some extent secured. They are platforms where you can buy and sell cryptocurrency or digital assets. You have to trust a third party to monitor the transaction and secure the assets on your behalf. Their deals aren't tracked on blockchain. Such exchanges require you to submit your personal information for verification. The more details you provide to the exchanges, the higher your withdrawal quotes will increase, or even your deposit quotes. Also, when you deposit your cryptocurrency onto the platform, you're basically transferring it to a wallet that is held by the exchange. When you deposit fiat currency, whether it's US dollar, in order to buy cryptocurrency, that crypto is also held in the exchange centralized wallet. So you decide to liquidate the crypto and withdraw the money back into your regular bank account. Most of these centralized exchanges provide you with what we call flat pairs, at stable prices like the likes of USDT, USD Coin, or even the popular Binance USD. Some very popular centralized exchanges, we have Binance, we have Coinbase, we have KuCoin, we have Crypto.com, and lots more. So using centralized exchanges, you do not have direct control over your purchases or your holdings. When you want to sell cryptocurrency or you want to buy, the exchange goes and finds another person who wants to buy or sell your cryptocurrency. It facilitates this transaction, and if you want to withdraw your cryptocurrency, you essentially have to ask the exchange to sign a transaction on your behalf. While on the other hand, decentralized exchange is similar to a centralized one, except it doesn't have a third party. All the funds in this exchange remain stored on the blockchain. You're in charge of everything. We have some very popular decentralized exchanges like PancakeSwap, Uniswap, SushiSwaps, and a lot of them. For you to be able to use any of these exchanges, you need to have your own wallet where you store your cryptocurrency. You can also use any of these very popular ones like MetaMask or Trust Wallet. There are actually lots of wallets you can use. To explain how decentralized exchange works, you're going to be using your wallet address to sign into blockchain decentralized exchange. You can submit a buy or sell request. Say for example, you want to swap. Maybe you want to sell your Ethereum for a different coin or token. The smart contract gets executed and transfer of assets is done. And always make sure to disconnect once you're done buying, you know, any of the centralized exchanges. There are definitely clear differences between these two and reasons why people choose one over the other or even use both, right? But I'm going to give you some very popular differences. The first one is going to be regulation. It is easier to regulate centralized exchanges than decentralized ones. Centralized platforms require licenses and they have to adhere to rules of the government in their region. While decentralized exchanges doesn't have any regulation because it's highly challenging to do so because of their distributed blockchain. This means that even if governments were to ban cryptocurrencies, decentralized exchanges can still operate in those regions. The second difference is registration. To be able to use centralized exchanges, you need to properly validate and verify to be able to buy or sell cryptocurrency. But for decentralized exchanges, no one will ever ask you about registration. You just go ahead and exchange your coins. The third difference also the features both of them offer. For centralized crypto exchanges, they have edge over decentralized ones. You can, you know, perform margin trading, you can use portfolio management tools and use multiple advanced other types to trade better. But on the other hand, decentralized crypto exchanges have quite limited types of order and don't offer margin trading as well to their customers. You can just basically swap, by maybe exchanging one token or the other, they really do not have a lot of futures, you know. So maybe later they can, you know, advance, but for now, decentralized and exchanges have very few futures that they offer. Now the fourth one is popularity. To some extent, we can argue that centralized crypto exchanges are more popular than decentralized ones because they came into the market first. Though decentralized exchanges have some advantages over them, but they are far behind in popularity. I'm sure if I tell you, if I ask you about SushiSwap, a lot of people might not even know what it means. They might just think it's a token. Alright, well, if I mention Binance or KuCoin, you already know that it's an exchange where you can buy or sell. But I think maybe as more decentralized exchanges enter the market, their popularity will increase considerably. Now, the fifth difference I would want to state is control. In a centralized crypto exchange, most of the control over your account remains in the hands of the third party. But on the other hand, with a decentralized exchange, all the control of the account remains with you. This is another huge reason why decentralized exchanges are becoming popular. And the final one I would want to state is security. This is a very big one in the crypto industry. Decentralized exchanges offer more security than centralized exchanges because of hackers. They can hack a third party which uses private key to access all the funds of the users in the centralized exchange, and you can lose all your deposits. Such incidents have occurred previously, and I think most of you would have heard about even the latest one that happened with Ethereum. I have a video that explained, you know, months ago how someone made over with $600 million stolen from an exchange. So centralized exchanges have put, you know, a lot of effort into making themselves more secure for their clients. But on the other hand, decentralized platforms are more secure because there is no possibility of multiple users losing their phone due to a single cause, unless it's related to the decentralized exchange gates. So it's more secure because, like, you are the one in charge of your wallet, you're the one in charge of your seed phrase, so someone needs to have access to that to be able to hack your account.
Also, another way your account can be hacked, whenever you're using a decentralized exchange, once you're done swapping, please do not forget to disconnect your wallet. If you don't disconnect your wallet, someone can actually have access to it and hack your account and take all your funds. So whenever you're done swapping or buying any coin on a decentralized exchange, always disconnect.
So choosing either the best decentralized exchange or centralized exchange is going to be completely up to you and the goals, you know, maybe which coins you want to invest in and all of that. If you want to use decentralized exchange, a higher responsibility is on you to safeguard your assets, since you're the one who is totally, you know, in charge of that account. So I would always want to tell you guys to be very safe out there. Be very, very safe out there, because there are lots of hackers roaming around the streets. And like I always mention, guys, cryptocurrency can be very volatile. So always, always, always use money you're willing to lose to be able to invest. And make sure you talk to a financial advisor before investing in any token. And I've noticed that a lot of people just buy coins because they hear it's very popular. It's always good to do your own due diligence by researching on the coin you want to invest in. What's the project about? Who are the people behind this project? What value does this project bring? So it also helps you even navigate a lot of scams. So this brings me to the end of this video. I hope now you're able to know the difference between centralized and decentralized exchanges. And hopefully, I will bring you guys another video, which is how you can actually create a wallet, maybe MetaMask or Trust Wallet. That's probably going to be the next video. I hope you guys like this video. Please make sure to subscribe to my channel, and I will see you guys in the next one. Let me know which video you want me to create for you. Leave it in the comment section and I will do that. I always read your comments. Thank you so much for supporting. Make sure to subscribe if you haven't, and I will see you in my next one. Bye guys.